amended, then the ministry will be able to take action based on that. But I want to thank Honorable Passaris and invite her to my office so that we can have deeper conversations. Thank you, Honorable Speaker and members.
Last on this, Om Chomba. Member for Githunguri.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. I rise to ask question number 1010 to the Cabinet Secretary for Health. Could the Cabinet Secretary clarify whether the National Health Insurance Fund, that is NHIF, has ceased remitting funds to private hospitals for provision of free maternity services? And if so, what steps are being taken to ensure continued access to these services by pregnant women, and particularly from low-income backgrounds? Two, explain the measures taken to ensure the continued operation and access to free maternity services under the Linda Mama Initiative, particularly in the light of Social Health Insurance Fund, yet to be fully implemented. And three, provide details on how the Social Health Insurance Fund will facilitate comprehensive access to reproductive health care for women. Thank you, Mr. Speaker.
Thank you, Minister.
Thank you, Honorable Speaker and Honorable Members. This is the question that ties up to the question that had been asked by Honorable Zamzam, and I wish to respond as follows. Honorable Speaker and Honorable Members, the free maternity services are financed by the Exchequer through National Hospital Insurance Fund on a fee-for-service arrangement. The fund has not ceased remitting funds to private hospitals for provision of these services, and mothers continue to get services from contracted facilities. Facilities in turn bill National Health Insurance Fund thereafter. However, there has been a delay in remittance of Exchequer from the National Treasury. The Ministry has engaged the National Treasury for release of 4.098 billion owed under the Linda Mama scheme. The Ministry has this week received a confirmation from Treasury on release of a total of 5.5 billion for NHIF, and of these, 2.5 billion is for Linda Mama. If we receive this 5.5 billion within this week, then payment of claims for Linda Mama will start from next week. On the second issue, explain measures taken to ensure the continued operation and access to free maternity services under Linda Mama Initiative, particularly in the light of Social Health Insurance Fund, yet to be fully implemented. Honorable Speaker and Honorable Members, the government enacted the Social Health Insurance Act 2023 to provide a framework for improved health outcomes and financial protection in line with the right to health and universal health coverage. The Act establishes the Social Health Authority that will manage the Primary Health Care Fund, Social Health Insurance Fund, and the Emergency Chronic and Critical Illness Fund. Maternity services have been provided as part of the scope of the benefits package to be accessed under Social Health Authority. To access the benefits package under Social Health Authority, all Kenyans are expected to register with Social Health Authority in line with the Social Health Insurance General Regulations of 2024. Benefits under SHA will start to be accessed from the 1st of July 2024. However, NHIF continues to operate, so there is no gap, and we are ensuring that there is a seamless transition. The government also recognizes that we have low-income households who may not be able to raise the minimum amount of 300 shillings for Social Health Authority. The government will, in this regard, pay premiums for these households who may include pregnant women in order to enable them access maternity services. This is in line with Section 27, Part 2C of the Act, which provides that in the case of households in need of financial assistance, as determined by the government at a rate appropriated by Parliament and County Assemblies for that purpose, as prescribed under this Act. Part 3, provide details on how the Social Health Insurance Fund will facilitate comprehensive access to productive health care for women. Honorable Speaker and honorable members, the Social Health Authority will facilitate comprehensive access to reproductive health care for women by providing explicit listed benefits accessible at level 2 and level 3 health facilities and at no cost to the member through the primary health care fund, which is fully financed by the government. A list of the benefits package of maternity services to be accessed through primary health care fund and Social Health Authority has been annexed to this presentation, and we shall leave it behind. Some of the benefits include access to family planning, antenatal care, pre and post delivery visits, deliveries, that is normal delivery and cesarean sections, complications related to deliveries. Just before and after the launch of the benefits package, the authority will invest in massive communication campaigns to inform mothers and all Kenyans of their entitlement to these benefits. Honorable Speaker and honorable members, I am aware that some members are thinking that Linda Mama has been scrapped and therefore there's no benefit for women. Honorable Speaker and honorable members, I wish to confirm that myself, I am a mother of two, and indeed, I am aspiring to be a mother of five. Therefore, the existence of Linda Mama will therefore ensure that all benefits under Linda Mama are ring-fenced, not just for myself as an aspiring mother, but for all the women of this country. Honorable Speaker and honorable members, I submit. Thank you.
Wamshomba. Let the questioner.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. I appreciate that we have gotten some response from the Cabinet Secretary concerning Linda Mama, and indeed congratulate her for aspiring to be a mother of five in the near future, and wish you well. However, Mr. Speaker, yesterday morning I visited a facility, a private facility in Kiambu County, after a few women alerted me that they have been apprehended in hospital because they were not able to pay for their medical care after delivery, and they held with them an NHIF card which was not admissible. I had to plead with the hospital to allow the mothers to leave the facility and give my personal guarantee that should they not be able to take care of their bills, I will do so as a mother. And therefore, when the minister tells us that she acknowledged that there has been a delay of remittance of some fund from Exchequer to some private facilities, she's right. And she says she's hopeful that that remittance is going to be done soon as possible. She says this week.
Ask your.
So the question is, what remedy should you give to such a mother who called me yesterday? What is she supposed to do when she goes to a hospital to deliver, noting that babies don't wait for next week for Exchequer to pay for the money? What remedy does the minister provide for that mother of Kenya who is now in hospital to deliver, has a card, and it is not admissible in private facility? Thank you.
The first joyrider, Irene Mayaka.
Thank you.